I received this Chelsea ship's clock today. The owner claims it had some rough treatment during shipment. The gong is broken off, and the hour hand has jumped a couple of teeth. I see. The gong is broken completely off its mount. Get this inspection plate off and see if the hammer is bent. While inside, the gong would be located just like this. It's a tight tolerance fit in the case. Check to see if the bell mechanism is working correctly. The hour hand is about a quarter of an hour off. The hour wheel must have jumped a couple of teeth when it was dropped. Remove this inner bezel. Now the movement. This is where the gong needs to be located. Looking at the break, I don't see but two small clean break marks. It almost looks like it was compromised years ago. Majority of the surface area shows very little signs of a recent break. Get this mount out of here and see what I'm up against. Looks like the piece that was mounted to the gong is mounted in a through hole. That's good. Not sure how they had the gong mounted to it yet. Was it a one piece, welded, or brazed? It'll mislocate the gong about a half an inch to relocate it in the brass mount. That's not an option. I'll remove the piece the gong was mounted to. Need some more weight under this. came out just fine. It's a brass color, but looks like it's made out of steel. Checking the OD, it's the same as the gong material. It was one piece at one time. Probably cut on a lathe, then formed into a coil after that. Maybe it wouldn't have broke if it had a radius at the transition point. These gongs need a solid mount, or they won't produce any tone. That's a little better. However I repair this, it's going to need to be solid. I'm going to drill a hole in the old broken piece, then push the gong into the hole. It's going to shorten it slightly, may change the tone a little bit. Now to see if a file will cut into it. If not, drilling is going to be tough. Good, the file cuts. So my high-speed drill bits will work. I'll finish up with two separate sizes to fit the taper of the gong. Find the center for the drill bit. I'll drill a pilot using a carbide bit. Now the small bit. And finish with the larger one. fits nicely. I could solder, braze, or weld it, but I don't want to risk the high heat damaging the tempered tone of the gong. So I'm going to use a cold repair, using a good grade of epoxy. Rough it up to give it some teeth for a good mechanical bond. I'll use this pin to hit against, so the hole doesn't get hit and deformed. Drive it in as far as possible, but still allow the gong to stick out within tolerance to the case sides, so the hammer will still contact it. Now to do a pre-fit and hope for the best. I'll use the 24-hour cure epoxy. It's the strongest. One thing about using epoxy, it's a cold repair and completely reversible. Use a heat repair on a gong and the outcome is questionable and non-reversible. Mount this in there while it's wet, so minor adjustments can be made. These shims will give about 40 thousandths clearance around it from the case. Well, it's been 24 hours. A portion of unused epoxy shows it cured just fine. Get these shims out. Sounds good. Now to correct the hour hand misalignment. Must have really taken a fall to mislocate the hour hand. Just need to pull up on the hour hand, rotate it a couple of teeth, then let it drop back down to lock it in. Looks good. Hope nothing else is damaged. Silent mode works good. Half hour mode. Odd number of gongs, good. Hour mode. Even number of gongs, great. The half hour again. The hour. And the half hour again. Sounds good. Now the inspection plate. Check to make sure these holes are symmetrical. And they are, so I can clock it in any position. threads on one of these screws is galled. The galled one is a little stiff. Some beeswax on it will help it run in smooth. Well, ready to go.